Welcome back to my channel. Since going on vacation at the moment is a little bit of a problem out of known reasons, well, I decided to take a look at old photos of mine, and I found photos from my last trip to Wales and the beautiful Castle of Caerphilly. And as I saw those photos, I thought back of a legend that was told to me. So today, let's talk about the ghost of Caerphilly Castle. As I mentioned before, Caerphilly Castle is located in Wales, and therefore also has a Welsh name, Castle Caerphilly. It was built in the 13th century by the Earl of Gloucester, Gilbert de Clare, and used as a stronghold against the Welsh tribes. Today, it's the largest castle of Wales, and the second largest of Great Britain, right after Windsor Castle. But I'm not going to bore you with more details about the history of this beautiful place. Instead, I want to talk about the most interesting part. The ghost of Caerphilly Castle. The story begins with the niece of Henry II and the wife of Gilbert de Clare, Alice de la Marche of Angoulême in France. Alice was known as a passionate woman with refined tastes. She was also said to have a bit of a wild side, which caused some problems between her and her husband during the marriage. And at some point she came to despise the warring deposition of Gilbert de Clare, and the disagreements between them grew bigger and bigger. But it happened that, while the marriage started to crumble, the pair was visited by Griffith the Fair, the Prince of Brythdeer, which is also in Wales. Since Alice wasn't happy in the marriage anymore, and Griffith was said to be a very handsome and well-spoken guy, it's no wonder she quickly fell in love with him. But Griffith, even though he loved her as she loved him, felt the guilt of having an affair with the wife of another. At some point, he wasn't able to bear the guilt alone anymore, and he confessed his sins to a monk. Little did he know that this monk was a loyal servant of Alice's husband, and so it didn't take long until the monk informed Gilbert de Clare about everything that happened. And you can imagine what happened next. Gilbert de Clare couldn't leave this insult unanswered. Full of rage, he sent Alice back to France, out of his sight and out of Griffith's reach. But that wasn't enough for de Clare. He also sent his man to hunt down Griffith and restore his honor. But Griffith wasn't as easy to get as de Clare would have wanted. Griffith quickly learned of the betrayal of the monk and of de Clare's plan to kill him. Seeing his own life shattered through the betrayal, Griffith hunted down the monk and hung him from a tree. But maybe Griffith should have spared the monk's life and run for his own, because soon after the execution, de Clare's man caught up with Griffith and did him as he did to the monk. Full of malicious joy, de Clare sent word to his unfaithful wife in France, informing her about her lover's death. But when Alice learned about Griffith's demise, she couldn't handle the fact that her lover was gone, executed by the hand of her own husband, only because she was unfaithful. And within moments, Alice died of shock and despair. And even though she died in France, her ghost is said to haunt Caerphilly Castle ever since. Some say you can still smell lavender around the castle, the scent of Alice's home in France, even though no lavender grows around the castle. Others say you can see her ghost on moonlit nights, mourning for her lover's fate. Do you believe in ghosts? Well, either way, Caerphilly Castle is definitely worth a visit. Even if you don't see the ghost, you can see the leaning tower of Caerphilly Castle. It leans at around 10 degrees, which is even more than the leaning tower of Pisa. And all in all, Caerphilly Castle is one of the most beautiful castles I've ever seen, so I definitely recommend you to visit it. I hope you liked this video. If you have any ghost stories from your own experience to share, leave a comment down below. Otherwise, see you next time. Bye!